Today's Investor Day covered a wide range of topics. But let's focus on the core of Master Plan 3, which aims to transition the world to a sustainable energy society. Currently, over 80% of global energy comes from fossil fuels. But only one-third of that energy is actually used for desired purposes or converted to heat due to low fossil fuel energy efficiency. Renewable energy has over twice the energy efficiency of fossil fuels. So let's assume it's twice as efficient from a conservative perspective. In that case, if we replace 82 PWH of the world's current energy consumption of 165 PWH with renewable energy, we can replace all fossil fuels. However, in many cases, even if it's theoretically possible, it's often considered too costly or physically impossible. First, let's look at the cost perspective. However, to change the world to a renewable energy society. However, we need a $10T investment over the next 20 years. However, this amount is only 60% of the investment that will be made in the fossil fuel industry over the next 20 years. Another misconception about renewable energy is that there is not enough physical space. However, the space needed to generate the energy the world needs through renewable energy accounts for less than 0.2% of the land on Earth. Specifically, for solar power generation, it only requires 0.14% of the land. And for wind power generation, only 0.03% of the land is needed to replace all the energy used on Earth. Considering that farmland accounts for only 12.5% of the total land area, this 0.2% is a very low ratio. Another misconception about renewable energy is that greater natural destruction occurs during this transition. The gray truck on the screen represents 1 gigaton of water extraction. The gray trucks represent the amount of mineral extraction currently used for fossil fuels. Fossil fuels require approximately 18 gigatons of mineral extraction. But if replaced with renewable energy, it will decrease to 4 gigatons. Another misconception is the amount of mineral resources. Some people think that we don't have enough resources to convert all energy to renewable energy. The resources listed on the screen are the key resources needed for the transition to renewable energy. Based on the confirmed reserves in 2023, it can be seen that for most resources, even if the total demand until 2050 is combined, it is only 5% of the reserves. Even for nickel and lithium, which are most needed, only 30% of the reserves are needed. Furthermore, many people think that reserves are decreasing rapidly every year, but the reality is that reserves are increasing due to newly discovered reserves every year. Once mined, these resources play a role in reducing the amount of mining needed in the future through recycling after they reach the end of their lifespan in batteries or power plants. To summarize Elon Musk's Master Plan 3 from Tesla Investor Day, the following is required to transition the world entirely to renewable energy: 240 TWH of energy storage, 30 TWH of renewable energy facilities, $10T investment in equipment, total energy demand reduced by half due to high renewable energy efficiency, less than 0.2% of total land area needed. The $10T investment cost is 10% of global GDP in 2022. And finally, 0% resource problems for achieving this.